Is my body given for you? This is the cup that holds the blood of the new covenant. This is forgiveness, simple and true. This is the way that I have made for you. Before you eat, before you drink, take a long look inside and tell me what you see. He said, do this in remembrance of me. Do this in remembrance of me.
My dear friends, the world famous Taj Mahal is well known to all of us. We know its beauty and grandeur. Yet, behind this beauty and grandeur is a sad story of love and sacrifice. And we know Sahajan built this world-famous monument in memory of his wife, Mumtaz, whose tomb is placed inside this great Taj Mahal. It is said it took the sacrifice of 22,000 artisans, a period of 20 years to complete this monument. And at the end of it all, Sahajan also ordered to cut off the hands of his artisans so that they would not replicate the structure anywhere else in the world. The people who sacrificed their life had to sacrifice even their hands being cut off to express Sahajan's love for his wife. My dear friends, today we celebrate the feast of the most precious body and blood of our Lord Jesus. It is a feast of the Holy Eucharist, also known as the Feast of Corpus Christi. And Eucharist as a story of love and sacrifice. It's a love of a person for humanity. It's a sacrifice of one person for the entire humanity. The story begins, my dear friends, in Egypt, when people of Israel were slaves. On the night before God was to free the people of Israel from the clutches of Pharaoh, he asked them to have a meal, which is the first Passover meal. We should remember, Jesus was a Jew. From childhood, he celebrated the Passover meal. Now, just before Jesus was to suffer and die, he told his disciples he wants to have the same Passover meal before he departs from them. But my dear friends, we see a remarkable difference in this Passover meal that Jesus has with his disciples. There is no lamb to be sacrificed, no blood to be sprinkled. Instead, this Passover meal of Jesus, where Jesus takes bread, breaks it, and gives it to his disciples, saying, "This is my body. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, he takes the cup filled with wine and says, "This is my blood poured for eternal covenant, poured for us for everlasting life." My dear friends, the significance is very clear. Jesus has become the sacrificial lamb. Jesus becomes the bread and wine. Then, now, today, the bread and wine becomes Jesus. And that's only the difference, my dear friends. Jesus becomes man so that we may become divine. And we may call God Abba, Father. We may become His children. Jesus says, I am the living bread. And at every Eucharist, we receive this living bread, my dear friends. As the Eucharist is not just a symbol like a Taj Mahal, Jesus is ever present at every Eucharist, inviting us to partake in that loving, sharing, and sacrificing ourselves for others. As we celebrate this feast of Corpus Christi, let us ask ourselves three questions, my dear friends. Am I convinced that Jesus is truly present in the Holy Eucharist, present in the Blessed Sacrament, present in our adoration chapels where He is waiting for us? And secondly, am I aware of the fact that I am the member of this body of Christ? And thirdly, my dear friends, how do I use my body as a channel of grace and instrument of this divine sacrament of divine salvation? Yes, my dear friends, as we celebrate this feast, I wish you all a happy feast of the most precious body and blood of Jesus.
Oh, how could it be that my God would welcome me into this mystery? Say, take this bread, take this wine, now the sample made divine for any to receive. By your mercy we come to your table, by your grace you are making us faithful. And remembrance leads us to worship, worship leads to communion. We respond to